Hi there everyone, my name is Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to show you how you can use an animation painter tool to mimic previous animations that were made in PowerPoint so that you don't have to recreate them and saves you a bunch of time. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so in my previous video, I showed you how to use the painter tool in PowerPoint. So if you haven't seen that video already, I recommend checking that out. I'll have the link to that in the description below. Another cool thing about the painter tool is that there's also an animation painter tool, and it does similar things to what the painter tool does for designs, but just does it for animations. So it'll mimic the same animations that you create, so you don't have to recreate them for multiple objects. So I'm going to show you guys what I mean by this exactly. So if I go into presentation mode here, and it says this one giant mountain, that text pops up, and then also up here, you'll see this dot appears, this line is wiping through from the left to right, and then the 1,000 feet is appearing. So let's say I want this animation that happened right here to be duplicated to this text, this line, and the circle, and also to this 50,000 feet text and line and circle, and then also have this, maybe this text down below, be duplicated as well. I'll show you guys how you can do that by just using the animation painter tool. So if you go here to the animations and then animations pane, you have to actually click on one of the animations in order for this animation painter option to open up. So let me click on this text right here, and it has a fade animation. And let's say I want this 80,000 feet to have the same exact animation. There's a couple of options that you can do here. One is you could obviously add the animation manually and try to match it. Or what you can do is you can click on this text, click on animation painter, and then click on this text, and now it's going to have the exact same animation style that this animation up here had. Now, if you want this line and this circle to be mimicked as well, all you have to do is click on this line right here, go ahead, animation painter, then click on this line, and now the animation is going to be mimicked right there. Lastly, let's say you want this circle animation to be mimicked as well, you can click on animation painter, and then click on this circle. So you may be wondering why to do the animation painter if all you have to do is copy and paste this and then just edit the text. You can do that as well, but let's say you're not wanting to move around all your shapes on the slide. It's nice to be able to just click and choose what you want things to be animated as without having to move them and then realign them on the page. So if I were to copy and paste this, yes, that entire animation is created, but then I have to remove it and line it up and everything. And sometimes people don't prefer to do that. So there's a couple of different options you can do there. So don't feel like you have to rely on Animation Painter to get the job done, but definitely can make things a lot quicker. So another thing I forgot to mention in my previous video for Format Painter is the option to add animations to more than one object at the same time. So let's say you really like this 100,000 feet animation. Double click on Animation Painter and now click on 80,000 feet. And then you can click on 50,000 feet. And you still have this painter brush available to you. So if you didn't click on it twice, if I just click on 100,000 feet, click on animation painter, I have this animation painter icon showing, but after I click on one object, it disappears. So if you ever want to mimic that style for more than one object at the same time, all you have to do is click on what you want mimicked, double click, and then you can click on whatever you want. And let's say you're done, just go back here and click on this, and that will stop the mimicking of those animations. You can do the same thing for Format Painter. So let's say I really like this text and I want to mimic for all these elevation heights. Double click on Format Painter. You can click on 50,000 feet, 80,000 feet, and 100,000 feet. And then all of those will be mimicked all at once. So it's a really cool trick to know just in case you don't want to have to re-click Format Painter and then copy the same style over and over. And it just saves you a little bit of time. So that is how you use the animation painter tool in PowerPoint. There's a bunch of different ways you can use this as well. Let's say you have multiple animations for one object. This will also mimic both of those animations at the same time, so feel free to play around with that. If you guys are wanting me to go even more in depth about the animation painter tool, let me know in the comments down below. But if you did like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I'm actually offering a course on Udemy, so make sure to check out the link in the description below to get all the details on that. Also, as a thank you for you guys for making it this far in the video, there's going to be a discount for that course, so make sure to look out for that in the description. Lastly, If you did like this video, make sure to let me know in the comments down below and what kind of videos you guys are looking for next related to PowerPoint. I'd love to take PowerPoint a step further, so I'd love to hear what you guys are looking for next. And with that being said, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.